Hi there, Simon from simonwoods.com. I have a couple of Portuguese white wines here. I'm not quite sure why they're not labelled Vinho Verde. They are from the northern part of the country, and they're labelled Vinho Regional Minho. This one's labelled Minho Superior, both from the same winery. Well, same group of wineries. This one's called Casa de Pacos and this one's called Quinta de Pacos. What's the difference? Oh, I don't know. Is it just to confuse us? Anyway, I'm going to set into them. Casa de Pacos 2016, Superior, made from blend. So, no idea what's in here, but let's give it a whirl. Smells crisp, bracing, almost Riesling-like with that slight citrus and herb bite. Smells like it's going to be perky and fresh, almost like a pithy grapefruit character. 12.5% alcohol, light, fresh, hopefully refreshing, and full-flavoured, light body. Let's have a see. Yeah, there is something almost Riesling-like about that, but what makes it more Vinho Verdine, if that's a word, not two words, is this, I often get this characteristic of pumice stone. I don't know if you used to have one of those things in the, when you're sitting in the bath, and people who use the same bath used to use things like that for exfoliation, and they had a particular smell, and it smells like that, this slightly a cool stony aroma, and alongside all this pithy citrus fruit. It's really nice. We're in the on one of the coldest days in December, so maybe it's not the sort of wine I really want to set into now, but actually, I probably wouldn't mind setting into that if I had enough shellfish on the side. Let's see what the second one's like. So this is Quinta de Pacos, again 2016, Morgado do Perdigão. And I don't know whether Morgado is... this Morgado de Perdigão was established by Alvaro Nunes, squire to King Manuel I in 1519 during the Portuguese discoveries period. The coat of arms was... Oh, you can, I'll point somewhere, you can read all about it. It's got history on the back. But it's 50-50 blend of Alvarinho and Loureiro. So let's give this one a whirl. Half a degree higher in alcohol and with more Alvarinho. So you're getting extra weight here. And it feels like it's a rounder, richer, slightly more exotic fruit flavours. Still got some of that pithy citrus character. But there's something slightly nut kernel, apricot kernels, and a little bit of nectarine too. Yes, it's almost as if someone's taken this and plumped it up, not pimped it up, plumped it up. They're same winery, but two fascinatingly different wines. This one here has that extra bit of weight. It's almost more a winter white. This is more the sort of thing I want to be drinking in December. The other one's very firmly on that cool summer summer thing that you want to have something refreshing. I like them both. It really would depend what I was eating, what time of year it was. They're both pretty nice wines. So I've got to finish this little slug in my glass. See you soon.